Thank you for joining us in the Yetter Solutions Center. Our Solutions Center videos discuss, explore, and evaluate the latest Yetter innovations while tackling the tough agronomy issues our industry faces.
Once you have the twister wheels installed, the next thing you need to do is check your spacing. So we recommend a good starting point is 1 3/8. And what we have found is that find a socket that measures the outside diameter is 1 3/8, which this one, we just got a regular 1 16th socket. And then you can just hold that socket down at the bottom while you rock those wheels back and forth to find the narrowest point. And we're right on there. That'll tell you real easy what your spacing is.
So I always say that there's really three parts to the closing system. That doesn't matter what style of wheel. When we have a V opening, there's three parts to closing that. Number one is we have to break the sidewalls. We have a nice firm V that we're putting the seat in. We have to penetrate that sidewall and break the sidewalls. Step two is we have to marry them two sides together. And by that, we don't mean sticking them together. We mean marrying the two sides together. And then step three is we have to firm that soil around the seat. And all three of them parts are equally important, but we have to do them in order. So, Alex, how would we dig? How would we be able to see if it's closed up from the top? How are we going to be able to dig to see what that performance actually is?
There's a lot of different ways we can dig. Andy's got a putty knife. That's a very common way. With that putty knife, we want to insert that into the row perpendicular to the row. And then after we've done that, we dig back away from it. And then you can pull that putty knife off. And that just gives you a cross section of your seed trench.
At that point in time, we can visually look at that. What we should see is nothing different on the left side than the right side. That should all be the same. We can visually look at that. After we visually look at that to make sure we don't have any air pockets or voids, now we can actually take my 1 inch and I will start digging from the top down, and we're going by feel here. We're going by feel to see if we have that resistance, because even if we close that seed trench up, it looks good visually, but then when we start digging around there, if we're not putting enough pressure, it's going to be very loose. And in the springtime, you know, we have good moisture in there, hopefully. When we put that seed down there, we close the seed trench up. We do a good job of everything except for that firming action. That's going to wick the moisture out, dry that seed zone all the way down there to the seed quicker. And so if we want to hold that moisture in there so that each seed can imbibe the moisture, and get that to germinate every seed within that same 12-hour period that we're hoping for, the firming action of the soil around the seed is extremely important.
So another way that I've seen that I really like is take a leaf blower to the field, and you can just start working your way down that seed trench and blowing that seed trench open. One thing I've found is that sometimes when you get to digging, and it depends on which direction you're digging from sometimes too, but you can cover up indications of the sidewall just by digging. Using a leaf blower is a different way to look at this seed trench. Now, am I saying that I want to get rid of the putty knife or get rid of my digging tool? No, but I like to have both in the field with me.
It's another tool.
It's another tool, and it's another way to see that seed trench. And maybe sometimes this leaf blower will show you something that the putty knife didn't, and vice versa.
And we have to look and get a visual down there into it. And some of these tools right here, the leaf blower, the putty knife, these are all tools that should be in your toolbox to help you to decide if you're doing a good job or if we need to make adjustments.
You know, most tailpieces come with two holes per side. Wouldn't you say the most common is probably in the rear hole?
I do, and we always get that question there. Certainly a viable question there.
From our testing and our experience, we like these side by side. I'm not real stringent on whether it's the front hole or the back hole, but I want them side by side. That action of marrying that soil together, like Andy talked about, it's like these work together. You want to push both sides together at the same time. So the one advantage I will say to the front hole, if you've got some contours and stuff, that front hole does track a little bit closer to the row unit, so it will track a little better on contours. The disadvantage to the front hole is if it's you got some wetter conditions, maybe a swale or two in the field is a little too wet, your row unit is just a little more prone to plugging with them tucked up closer to that row unit.
Thank you for joining us today. Be sure to check out our complete Yetter Solutions Center playlist at YouTube. And as always, we're here to help you find profitable solutions for your operation. So, if you need more information or have a topic idea for a future episode, drop an email to solutions@yetterco.com.